should have stayed in your muscle.
Hey, what's up guys, this is Destiny Cat. I'm back with another video, and today I'm going to be doing a Frost tutorial slash guide. As I'm mainly Frost at the moment, I thought it would be appropriate to show you what I've learned and what I'm personally using, what kind of combos I'm using, what kind of, you know, things I'm using when I'm playing her. Keep in mind I will be playing the showing off the Ice Machine variation. Guiding the Ice Machine variation, so this is a competitive variation, so you know, no custom variations, this is competitive mode only. I will not be like talking about the other variation. I can't remember the name of it, but the one with the setups with the head, as I don't think it's as good as this one, and whatever I see people play Frost, they always play Ice Machine, so this is what we're going to be focusing on. So what we're going to do is we're going to break this guide down into some different segments, four to be exact. First we're going to look at her strings slash special moves, then we're going to look at how to play neutral with her, then we're going to look at some crushing blows, and then finally we're going to be looking at the combos, which is what I know a lot of you guys are here for, but if you want to be good at MK, you gotta have some neutral as well. So let's get into the strings. Her main and most powerful string is back 2-2, or rather you'd think it's as powerful as it looks. Very good. It also goes into back 2-2-1-2, which is a double overhead, but it's unsafe, so I recommend staying away from it. But back 2-2 is minus 5 on block. If you see it hits, you can go into her down back 4 meter burn, or amplified. And if you don't see it hit, if your opponent blocks it, you just kind of stay there as your minus 5 on block. Keep in mind that if you do this from really far away, the down back 4 will not connect. So from max distance, you actually cannot combo. There you can, but if you go like here, you actually cannot combo down back 4, which is a little bit of a bummer. So just keep that in mind, that you cannot combo there. But if you see it hit from like here, no problem. However, as powerful as it looks, it also has a weakness that makes it sometimes really dangerous to use. Let me show you right here. And the weakness is... that you can flawless block it. Big problem, as a lot of people are starting to catch on to this. I recommend being very careful about throwing this move out in neutral, and unless you can guarantee that it hits, because people can flawless block it pretty easily if they know the timing. I always don't, because I'm pretty bad, but I'll get used to it. But it's it requires a little bit of timing. But if your opponent knows about this, you're in a lot of trouble, because they can basically flawless block every time you do back to two. It doesn't matter when you throw it after it. If you just flawless block it and punish it, then you're in a lot of trouble, dude. So just be careful about throwing it out there. I'll return to the move later and show you some other things you can do instead if you're afraid the opponent's got flawless block. Next string I want to look at is 1-3. 1-3 goes into 1-3-2 and 1-3-4. 1-3-2 is a plus 3 mid ending into the mid, and it's plus 3 on block. 1-3-4 is minus 2, I believe. Let me say again. Yeah. And it's overhead, so this is pretty good because you don't have a lot of overheads. You actually don't have almost any overheads. So this is a safe overhead you can do at the end of a string, which is not bad because, again, you want to mix the opponent as much as possible, even though you don't really have overhead starter. So those two strings you should be careful of, but you should use those in neutral and for pressure. Both back three, both 1-3-2 and 1-3-4. Keep in mind that 1-3-4, it might be plus 3 on block, but it is very rarely that you can actually get anything off it, as it pushes the opponent very far away. Now, another string you want to look at is one of her best strings, it's 3-4-4. 3-4-4 also goes into 2, which is an overhead. It's unsafe, so I'd recommend staying away from it, as you are completely safe off 3-4-4. You can also hit confirm it into down back 4 and get a combo. Or you can, if you block it, you can go into down 4-2 to be a little bit less unsafe. But we'll get into that later. So that's one of her main strengths. It's also very good for low profiling jump-ins and high attacks. If you are ready, if you read that the opponent's going to throw a projectile from here or something, you can actually punish with this. Very good string. Another string that you should be using is back 3-2 down 1. The problem with this string is that it's unsafe, so you wanna hit confirm it. Basically, if you see your opponent blocking, you just do back 3-2. And if your opponent doesn't block, you go into the full string. And you get a full combo of it. Not bad at all. Another string you wanna be using is 2-2. Plus 5 on block. And sadly, you cannot hit confirm it into this, because it won't reach, but you can hit confirm into something like that, or like that. So overall, not too shabby. Not too shabby at all. It also goes into 2-2-3, which is a low, unsafe on block sadly, but so I wouldn't really recommend using it unless you are certain the opponent isn't going to block low, which, let's be honest, it probably will since you're playing Frost and don't really have an overhead. So I wouldn't recommend throwing it out at all. But 2-2 is fine as it is. What else strings do you want to use? Back 1-2-1 is pretty good. Just the first back 1-2 is pretty good, as you can cancel it and confirm it into a double back 4 enhanced or amplified, and you get a nice little combo from that. It's also save on block if you want to go for the full string, but it's kind of slow at 19 frames, so I wouldn't really recommend throwing it out there too much. 4-3 is also a good string. Mainly in the corner to extend some combos, but it's not that good mid-screen, but it can be used as kind of a back 2-2 substitute if you are afraid the opponent's going to flawless block and you can kind of throw this out there. As it is completely safe, actually plus 3 on block, so I would recommend using it as it can be pretty nice to get those plus 3 frames. It also leaves the opponent pretty close, so you can actually jam a down 1 there, or just keep doing it if your opponent respects you too much. But again, it is kind of slow at 20 frames, so yeah, be careful with that. Let's go into some of her normals that you should be using. Mainly 4-2 is her best normal, but like her back 2-2, it has a ginormous weakness, and that is the opponent can actually just crouch it. But not just can they crouch it, they can actually crouch block it, and it'll still whiff, which is a big problem. It's a very big problem, because that way you can just get a full punish on you, and you really want to be careful with that. But if you are certain the opponent isn't going to block it, or actually if you block it, it's fine because you're 0 on block, but if you're certain the opponent's going to dodge it, you can just throw it out there. You can also react to the opponent jumping at you, which I've done a few times, and punish it with that. Also, it's a pretty nice knockdown for some oaky stuff, but it's not a string or something you want to be throwing out too much, as it becomes pretty predictable. Other than that, with down 4 is very good. Look at the range on this, you can actually hit the opponent from the start of the match almost. Not quite, but it's close. It has a lot of range. Down 3 is really bad, you would never use it. Sometimes I do use it, but don't use it much. Down 1 is good. Down 4 and down 1 are very good. This one has a lot of range on it, even though for down 1 it has a lot of range. Like you can hit him from all the way over here, which is very nice. You can actually hit him from very all the way over here almost. Didn't do that. So it's a very good down 1. Down 4 is just insane. It's one of the best down 4s I've seen in the game so far, in my opinion. With the range, of course, and the she ducks as well, which is nice. So let's go into some of her special moves. So she's got down 4-2. One of her best ways to end block strings. Does quite a lot of chip, and it's only minus 4 on block, I believe it is. Yeah, minus 4 on block. Very nice. Meter burn is minus 5 on block, but does a lot of chip. And this is a way you can actually trick your opponent a bit. For example, you can go for back 2-2 and then start on block, which is very good. Because then they might try to punish your back 2-2, or try to dead turn because you're minus 5 or whatever, but then you go into that and some people could cut off by it. You can also, amplify it, so your opponent will get cut off by that. It's all one very nice and does a lot of chip damage, so you should be using that a lot. Then he's got down back 2. Can be thrown at 3 different ranges: close, medium, and far. overall decent projectile. But what's really cool about it is that it isn't actually considered a projectile, so you can still hit Jade with it, which can be useful if you're playing that matchup. Another thing is a back 4-3. Pretty standard projectile. I like it throws out too, but it's very, very slow. Very slow, and it won't win a zoning war. You can use it to chip the opponent out though, which I've done a few times in my matches, because, for example, after you've knocked the opponent full screen with this, it's a very good follow-up to go for things like that, so you can be like, you can come for that, and you go for that. Try to trip the opponent out, that's what it's very good at. Then she has got her back 4-4, which is also very powerful. Very good combo ender. Enhancing it will basically send the opponent to the corner, which isn't bad. But mainly, mainly it's your best combo ender, most damaging combo ender, and it's just very nice. Then she has also got her down back 4, which is her main combo start if you amplify it, but it can also be used as a combo ender, just the normal one in some situations. This thing is useless, never use it, don't even think about it. I've had it come out on as an input error a few times, but it's one of the most useless things that she has, and you would never want to use it. Alright, so now that we've taken a look at her strings, let's take a look at her neutral. So in neutral, obviously you want to be doing things like down 4 a lot, because you have a lot of range on it, back 2-2, as a whiff punisher, be careful throwing out there in neutral, and overall use your 4-2 to get in there. You kind of want to be staying around this range, where your back 2-2 can hit the opponent and still be able to combo. You don't want to stay all the way out here, because then your back 2 won't be able to combo, but a little bit closer and your back 2 will be able to combo easily, leading to a full combo. So this is definitely what you want to be doing. You want to be kind of staying here at the mid range type of thing. But you can also be, depending on the matchup, you can also be trying to do go for a zoning strategy with things like this, which isn't bad. But overall, she's more of a mid-range character. You want to be as range with this, where you can hit with your downfall, your back 2-2, your 3-4-4, and your 4-2. Your main strings that you want to be using in neutral. So yeah, that's pretty simple. As for mixing your opponent up, I know this isn't really a part of neutral, but you know, I want to cover it here. Since she doesn't have an overhead, you want to be using your hop attacks a lot. Simply because she doesn't have an overhead. Also want to be doing things like this, going for the low right there, like that. Hit confirming it, of course. But things like that is really what you want to be doing with Frost. So overall, just use your hop attacks a lot, even though they're unsafe, just because your opponent won't be expecting an overhead. Use your throws a lot to basically mix your opponent up and gain yourself some space. Your throws can be very good at doing that. Alright, let's be looking at some of her crushing blows now. She obviously has the universal down 2 crushing blow, but you can actually get a lot of damage off it. I'm going to kind of be looking at the crushing blows into combos as well, because they kind of fall into the same category. Off this, you can actually get a lot of damage, but just go for this, it's actually pretty good as well. You know, 30% off crushing blow isn't bad, but you can actually get a lot of damage here. It's pretty good, as you can see. Can be very deadly and does a lot of damage. But you know, I'd mainly just go for the 1-3 ender into something, because it's just easier to do. Her other crushing blow she has is this. If you enhance this 3 times, amplify it 3 times. I'm gonna put my meter to full. So if you amplify it 3 times in a row, the third one will actually crushing blow into and it'll launch. So let me show you what I mean right here. You can actually get a lot of damage in the corner of it. If I didn't drop it, of course. So overall, it's very good. You can see here, this is good damage. 42%, not bad at all. So yeah, that is not bad at all. Another one of her crushing blows is her back 2-2-1-2, which is a crushing blow if it's a counter hit or punish. So let me show you what I mean right here. Put the opponent to throw. And actually, I'll recommend just doing the same combo, just for consistency. Still, it's not that much damage actually, it's only 34%. So that's pretty good, but keep in mind you mainly only want to be using that mid in the corner, because mid-screen it really doesn't do much. That is all her crushing blows, except for her throw one, which is if the opponent takes wrong, then the next throw will crushing blow and does like 31%. I don't think I need to show that one, but that's also very good. Alright, so now that we have looked at some of her stuff and how to play neutral with her and how to zone with her, things like that, we want to be looking at some combos, guys, so check this out. Alright guys, so looking at Frost's combos, mid-screen, the way that you basically want to start all your combos is just, you know, any string, so it could be 1-3 into this. Or it could be this 3-4-4 into it, or things like, oh, it could be oh, like 2-2. That doesn't work. It could be back 1-2 into it. Of course, back 2-2. Again, main whiff punisher. Then after that, you want to always go into back 3-2-down-1. Usually, you want to do a jump 2 to get more damage, so like that. And then you have options to end your combos with. There are 3 different options. So let me show you the first one here. Jump into 2-down-1. 1-3 into that. This is a very good combo ender, as it leaves the opponent close to you, which means that you can actually enforce some mix-ups. I really like going for this if I want some oki against my opponent. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Very simple, so it's just 1-3 into close, what's it called? Down back 2. Core discharge. Close core discharge. You want to walk forward a little bit as well. Dash up throw, for example. This is basically your way of getting some oki on like mid screen. In the corner, you have a better way to do it, but I'll get into that once we get into the corner combos. So yeah, that is very good to keep your opponent close. If you want the opponent a little bit farther away and do some damage, this is the combo ender for you. Again, this all depends on the matchup. This keeps the opponent kind of like 2 jumps away from you, which can be pretty nice if you want to keep that distance. And finally, if you want the opponent to be full screen and start zoning them, this is the combo ender you want to go for. You go full screen, you can start zoning them. Very nice. So those are the 3 combos you want to be doing in mid-screen. In the corner, once you get your opponent to the corner, you want to keep in mind that back 3-2-down-1, actually you can double these. You can do 2 of them in the corner, and it'll actually combo if you time it right. You gotta do it very early though, so you don't drop it. Like that. And you get a lot of damage off that. So, first let's take a look at what you do if you hit him with down back 4. You know, amplified. You do a jump 2, and you do your back 3-2-down-1 twice. Let me show what I mean here. Walk back and do a jump 2, you can also just jump in place, but I find it easier to do this. And then you end in this. It's better to end in this, like back 4-4, than ending in this in the corner. Because back 4-4 keeps you in a good distance away from your opponent, which makes it easier to dodge their wake-up attacks. So let me put my opponent to get-up attack. I think it's Ice Spike. Yep. So what do you want to do, for example, let's say you catch them with here, and you think they're going to wake-up attack, or you might be, you know, ready for it, you wanna be ready for the wake-up attack. This is what you do. Do this, then you back up, and then you can punish it if you see it coming out, and then you can just do the same combo over and over again until they stop wake upping, and at that point you can go for a throw or something. So that's the basic idea for a corner game. You always want to be ending in this. If you're doing, you know, a combo like that, you always want to be ending in 1-3 into that, or just, you know, it could be standing 3 into it, but I recommend doing 1-3. It does the most damage, simply because that space you're getting that you don't get from this. Now, something else you can do is you can go for a oki setup in the corner, which looks like this. prone to of. This leaves the opponent in a very weird and annoying knockdown for them, which makes you able to do some mix-ups on their way on their get-up mode or on their Oki. So you can do things like you can do things like let me show you here. Can with this. Oh. Do an overhead to mix them and do another overhead, for example. Or you can do you have a lot of options here. You can go for throw, for example, of it, or you can go for like a back throw. You can go for another left, expecting the overhead. You can do like a fake jump or fake hop into a low, which can lead to a lot of damage. So that's another thing you can do in the corner. If you want a lot of damage for Frost, the way to get it is you want to start a combo in low, so you want your opponent to block high for a second, you can go them with low. This is the combo you want to be doing, and the damage is actually really good for Frost. 35% off of that. You can get more if you do jump 2, but it's not very likely you'll get that in an actual match. And again, you want to be ending in back fold 4 to get that spacing. So those are the main combos that you want to be doing with Frost in the corner and mid-screen. And that brings us to the end of this guide, guys. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions regarding Frost, then leave them down in the comments. Tell me in the comments if you enjoyed this guide, or if you think there was something important that I left out. Also, please make sure to tell me. Right now, I'm going to be maining Frost. At least see whether it takes me, because I really enjoy the character. She's really fun to play. That's all I have to say for now, guys. Hope you find it useful. I hope you found this video useful. Thank you guys for watching. This is Destiny Cat 249 signing out. Have a good day, guys.